this game workshop, we're going to make a caricature using the Warp Transform tool. When you want to follow along, the download link for the images is in the video description. Go to your image folder and right-click on the image of the lion. Then we go to Open With and click on GIMP. Now we go to the toolbox and we activate the Free Select tool. We will first make a selection of the head of the lion. We can just click several nodes in the black of the background, like so. When we hold the Control key and roll the mouse wheel, we can zoom in or out. In the manes of the lion, we make sort of a zigzag selection. When we press and hold the mouse wheel, we can move the whole image by moving the mouse. When we are back at the first node, we click the last node over the first one. Then we double-click in the selection. Go to View, Zoom and Fit Image in the window. In the menu bar, we click on Select and then on Feather. We can feather the selection with 15 pixels and click OK. Now we go to Edit and click on Copy. Back to Edit and now on Paste. Click on the New Layer button to change the floating layer into a normal layer. Double-click on the name and rename it Lion's Head. Hit Enter. Make the Unified Transform tool active. We make the image opacity about 50. Under Constraint we check the option Scale. In this way the proportions stay intact when we scale the image. Now we click in the image. Scale the image by click and drag in the squares at the corners, but not in the diamonds. We can move the whole image by click and drag inside the framework. And when we click and drag outside the framework, we can rotate the image a bit, like so. When we think it looks okay, we can click Transform. Go to Layer and hit Layer to Image Size. In the next step we are going to work with the Warp tool. Go to the toolbox and click on the Warp Transform tool. In the Behavior drop-down menu we click on Grow Area. Then we make the size about 150. Go ahead and place the cursor between the eyes and zoom in a bit. Make sure that both eyes stay visible. Now we place the cursor in the center of one of the eyes. Then click without moving the mouse 15 to 20 times. Then we do the same with the other eye. Now zoom out a bit. Back to the Behavior menu and now we click on Shrink Area. We make the nose a bit smaller, like so. Again to Behavior and now click on Move Pixels. We make the beard a bit longer. Then we move the mouth corners a bit upwards. And both lips a bit downwards. Change the size to 300 and make the nose smaller. Enlarge the size to about 500. Now we choose the option Swirl Clockwise. We change the manes on the left like so. Click Swirl Counterclockwise and change the manes on the right in the opposite way. When certain areas are not to our liking, we can click Erase Warping. Then we can erase the areas that we do not like back to their original shape. Now we can try again. Until now, we have made changes in the top layer. Before going to the bottom layer, we first have to hit Enter to confirm these changes, otherwise we lose them all when we activate the bottom layer. When we have pressed the Enter key, the changes are permanent and cannot be erased anymore. So, hit Enter and make the bottom layer active. We can always click Ctrl-Shift-J to maximize the image in the window. In that way, we have an overall view of our work. Click the option Shrink Area. Make the size 400. Then we shrink both the front legs, like shown in the video. Click Move Pixels again, and make the size about 200. Lower the back of the lion, and pull up the knee a bit. When we feel it's okay, we hit Enter to confirm these changes. Make the top layer active. In the next step, we will bring the glasses into our project. Go to File, click Open as Layers, and open the image of the glasses. Click the Unified Transform tool active again. Go ahead and click in the image. Click and drag the square, but not the diamond at the corner, to scale the glasses. Then click and drag inside the framework to move them. And finally, click and drag outside the framework to rotate them like so. When satisfied with the result, we can click Transform. In the next step, we will add a bit of a shadow under the glasses. Go to Layers and click on New Layer. Name it Shadow Glasses. The mode should be normal, and the fill should be transparency. Click OK. Hit the downwards pointing arrow at the bottom of the layers panel to place this layer below the layer of the glasses. Now we go to the toolbox and click on the paintbrush. Make the opacity 15. We should have brush hardness 0.50, and we make the size 40. Zoom in and paint the shadow below the left and the right glass. When all this looks good, we press Ctrl-Shift-J once more, and there it is, our own caricature image. I hope you have fun with this tutorial. If so, please do not forget to give it a thumbs up. Thank you very much for watching.